Okay, welcome back. The Yetis are hungry for more. Time for game two. Let's go. Yeah, I like that hand. That looks like a hand. Let's keep that. Not having a 2-drop is a bit suboptimal, but having a Wump and a Sadrog is pretty good. Let's hope they live. Oh, we found a 2-drop. How lucky. I'll play Primal Sigil over the Waystone. It's not likely that we can hold it back long enough to activate, but might as well try if it has no downside. I guess here we go for the fire influence. Womp. Could play this, but attacking is really good here. Gets us in a lot of damage and sets up stuff. So yeah. What he's playing actually doesn't have much ways to deal with Womp, which means we can Sadrog next turn, which is great. And then bond out Pok Pok. This might be yet another great game. Snowball giving us a card to Merchant away, which is sweet. And with Womp out, Pok Pok's pretty decent attacker.
Something catch your eye.
That unfortunately shuts down our Sadrog. Can try and set up a I think what we want to do here first is attack. Can try and go for scouting party. It's probably the best plan.
Something
I think I like
that.
Let's get a scouting party. That's cute.
Little brothers, let us feast.
There's what we were hoping for. Boom. Face Aegis ate it. That was stupid. I completely forgot about a Face Aegis. I should have played Fearless Yeti. This turn. Attack with all those, because, yeah, deals some damage and trades here, which is quite good. Let's see if he has a way to deal with this. Not sure what his deck is running. Initially I thought he's like the Chancellor type deck, but seems like not. But yeah, looks like he's dead. Get his OP! Glorious is the right word for what we were doing here. Very glorious. Yeah, if you can't interact, you can't beat Yetis, actually. The deck is super strong if the opponent has no interaction. Just beats what most decks do if you don't interact with it. Like, if you can't kill Womp, you're not gonna win. The stuff that deck does is way too broken with Womp active. If scouting party is a 6 power, draw 4, make 4 2-2s, deal 4 damage to the opponent, it's like a cruel ultimatum level for anyone that played Magic. And better than that. It's just like 6 power, I win the game. Like we just saw. And that was even with the face E just blocking it and still just crushing it. So it didn't even deal the 4 damage and drew the 4 cards and it still just obliterated the opponent. So yeah, we are 2-0. Eternal Bruce crushing it. Ahorn came up with a really good core for the deck and I just gave it some fine-tuning to max it out, I think. And we are doing really well. This was one of the spots where Unseal being Caleb's choice would have technically been better, but I think even there it's like you're probably not gonna get it, you just get scouting party, so it doesn't really matter. But that's one of the narrow cases where Caleb's choice can at least be interesting or relevant to free that Sadrog. But the thing is, not being able to counter everything and not being able to to counter everything is problematic. And also the fact that sometimes, even though it is unlikely to happen, when you don't have fire, Unseal still works also, so it just has a few minor upsides over choice, where choice does not have much upside over Unseal, relevant upside anyway. So that's why I chose to stick to Unseal and not play Caleb's choice. For example, countering cards like a Great Parliament or a Stand Together can be very relevant, for example. Alright, anyway, that's it for game 2. See you in a moment for game number 3 with more Yeti power.